continue, prof. Prof Ade, sir.
Good evening, sir. Yes, good evening, sir.
Okay.
I hear you.
We are just finding it difficult to sign in to this foundation class. Why is it like that? Okay. Sorry, can you? Okay, my video is not. Is my screen showing?
Yes, it is, sir.
All right, okay. So let me just wait for the students.
Can we for some students to come in?
All right. Thank you. So do have a nice evening by lying down on your bed.
Thank you, sir.
So I'm giving you cold. So if I know that then I'm the host. All right, take care. Thank you. where we gave different reasons why there could be a discrepancy between the bank balance and bank balance ledger and the bank statement. We also discuss extensively on how to reconcile our account, where we talked about adjusting the cash book and preparing the bank statement. So today, we are going to be discussing different things entirely. But it's going to be a build up on what we have actually discussed in the past, either through the second lecturer, Mr. Israel, or through what I've actually discussed with us. So I will not go through the rule of the class because we know the rule by now, and we are actually following the rule. So I will not just bother myself to discuss. To discuss about the rule of reconciliation. That is what he wants to discuss. Control account reconciliation. Now, when it comes to the control account, there are two important accounts that actually form the control account of a financial statement. There are two important accounts. They are just so important. And this account, we call them control accounts. They form the control account in the financial statement. These are payable control account and a receivable control account. All right. So before we talked about them, those two accounts, how we can actually reconcile them. Today, I believe that we are going to learn about understanding the relationship between the control account and the subsidiary ledger for account receivable and account payable. And we also learn about an account payable. And at the end, we also learn on how to identify error and correct error from various control accounts that we have. So in form of introduction, in the past, we have learned about sales and purchase day book, on how to maintain sales and purchases day book, how to post transaction there, and what type of transaction that we post into sales day book and purchases day book. Now, and today, the total from the day books, this important, this sales day book and purchase day book are posted to control account in the general ledger. For like sales day book, that's to do with the debtor, with your client. So the total in the client account, in the sales day book account, is going to be posted into receivable control account. While the total in the purchases day book is an account that I'll see the transaction that relate to your supplier or creditor. You can call it creditor or supplier. So all these transactions, the total of this and purchases day book will be posted to payable control account in our ledger. And you also need to know that These are supported, you know, by a separate record, which is a list of individual balances that comprise the total in the general ledger. Now, a control account is an account which represents a total value of a number of a separate balances. In an organization, it's very obvious that an organization will have more than one creditor or more than one debtor, which we call customer. Now, the aggregate of all the customer that they have, the aggregate transaction of all their the customer that they have, the balance, is what is actually going to receivable control account. At the same time, the aggregate of individual creditor account, the transaction that we have there, is what goes to purchases control, payable control account. Now, this lecture is going to be divided into subheading. The first one that we are going to be taking, that we're going to be considering this evening, is the receivable control account. Receivable control account. Okay. So, receivable control account. What is receivable control account? So after considering the receivable control account, we also go ahead and consider how to reconcile receivable control account. Thereafter, we move to payable control account. And after that, we go to how to reconcile reconciliation of payable control account. So let's start with the receivable control account. The receivable control account is an account for recording the value of transaction in total with credit customer. You know, you might always have a credit customer, a customer that you make a sales to, but they don't pay the money immediately. Because if you make a sales to your customer and customer do not make payment immediately, this is what go to your sales day book. As the name implies, this is what actually go to your sales day book. And the balance on this receivable control account, which usually going to be a debit balance, is the total amount currently owned by all customer. Note very well. The balance in the receivable control account, which is going to be a debit balance, is the total amount currently owned by all your customer. So the receivable control account will contain some or all of the total to date for all the following posting to the account. Everything that you have posted to the account, the total in that particular account is what is going to make up your receivable control account. Now, it's very possible for your receivable control account not to balance with the individual credit and individual suppliers account. This is the reason why reconciliation is very, very important. The same way that we have reconciliation with the bank is the same way that we also have reconciliation with the ledger, which is the receivable control account this time around. Okay. So I have a format here on how the receivable control account will look like. I have a format here on how the receivable control account will look like. Receivable control account is actually an asset account. I believe that Mr. Israel has actually taught us this one. Receivable account is an asset account. An asset account, we always have what balance? A debit balance account. That is why I said the aggregate in your sales day book, which is posted to the receivable control account, you always have a debit balance. You always have a debit balance because of what? Because it's an asset account. It's the money that your customer is actually owing you. So this is the format of a receivable control account. At the debit side of the receivable control account, we have an opening balance, which is called balance brought forward or balance brought down. You have an opening balance, balance brought down. And after that, you have a sales. Every sales that you make is actually posted, is debit to the, what's it called? Is debit to your receivable control account. And you also have what is called a dishonor check at the debit side. At the same time, what goes to your credit side will be transactions such like bad debt. If you are writing off any debt from a receivable, so that particular transaction is going to be posted to the credit side of the receivable control account. At the same time, you can also have a cash payment. If there is any payment that the supplier made, it's going to be posted by debiting your bank and crediting this receivable control account. And at the same time, you can also have what is called a contract credit note. Contract credit note. And another transaction that you can find under the receivable control account in the credit side is discount allowed. You know, when you allow discount, we have what is called we have discount allowed, and we at the same time we have a discount received. A discount allowed is a credit entry to the receivable control account, because the discount allowed will make the balance in the receivable control account to reduce. The discount allowed will make the balance in the receivable control account receivable control account to reduce. So that's actually the format. That's some of the transactions that you can actually see under the receivable control. So apart from this, we have another format. Apart from this one, I'm going to show us another format under how to reconcile the receivable control account. So our take home under this receivable control account is that the account has to be a debit balance. Yes, the account has to be a debit balance. And is an aggregate of 6-day book that we posted to a receivable control account. So another thing that we need to know about receivable control account is that how do we now reconcile a receivable control account if the account does not balance, if the aggregate in the 6-day book does not balance with a receivable control account? It means that there is something that is actually missing. Either there is a particular transaction that is being posted, that is being posted into the wrong account, or either there is an omission in a particular customer's account, or there is a transposition error in a particular account. So, this account needs to be reconciled in order for you to have a true fear or true position of your account at the end of a particular period. So how do we reconcile a receivable control account? So that will make us to move into what is called receivable control account reconciliation. Receivable control account reconciliation. Now, reconciliation means making sure that two figures or total are consistent with each other or agree with each other. That is what the reconciliation is. Two figure A in account A is actually reconciled with account B because you are expecting them to reconcile. That is what the reconciliation is all about. So the control account in an accounting system can be used for control purposes to make sure that transactions have been recorded correctly in the account. You need to post correctly in order for you to make sure that the transaction has been recorded correctly. And at the same time, you need to also reconcile your account maybe at the end of a particular period or at the end of a particular day or at the end of a particular period set by the management. So that is the main reason why the receivable control account is actually very, very important. Now, a reconciliation check can be made to make sure that these total are the same. And if they are different, the cause of the error should be found and also should be corrected if they are different. because of the error, you need to actually discover, you need to actually look for the cause of the error, and the error are corrected or are reconciled. We use the word reconcile in account. So the error are actually reconciled for you to make sure that what you are seeing in individual account is actually total what you are seeing in your receivable control account. So a receivable control account reconciliation involves a comparison between the total and looking for the reason for any difference between them and correcting error that are discovered in the checking process. Oh, so what am I trying to say? The receivable control account reconciliation now, because I have actually seen in an I can pass question before where they ask us to write short notes about receivable control account and receivable control account reconciliation. They are different between receivable control account and receivable control account reconciliation. Now, the receivable control account is the aggregate of all the individual customers' account that is being posted to the receivable control account. Meanwhile, receivable control account reconciliation is the reconciliation prepared to check any discrepancies that can happen between the individual's customer's account and receivable control account. And the difference will actually be caused via different error, and the error needs to be identified and reconciled as the case may be. So that's the difference between receivable control account and receivable control account reconciliation. So what are the things that can actually cause error? What are those things that can actually cause error between the receivable control account and the individual customer's account? What are those things? So I will just mention them one after the other. I think I have like a 4 points here. There are more than this, but I have like a 4 points here. We'll mention them and we just move on. Number one, error number one. The total of the credit sales in the sales day book is correctly debited to the receivable control account, but one of the individual transactions is not posted from the sales day book to the individual account in the receivable ledger. What am I saying? If the receivable, the credit sales day book is actually posted to the receivable control account, but there is an omission whereby an account was omitted, a customer account, maybe a customer account was actually omitted, was not posted to the receivable ledger. No, this can actually cause error, and this can actually cause imbalance or discrepancies between a receivable control account and the customer ledger account. So how do we correct this one? You need to just adjust the individual customer balance. That particular individual customer balance is what you need to just adjust. What am I trying to say? A customer that is owing you 500 naira, you know, and it was that 500 naira was omitted. When you are trying to add up all the customer that is owing you and posting it to receivable control account, you know, at the end of the day, your receivable control account will be understated by that particular 500 naira that the creditor and the customer is owing you. So if the customer, if the receivable control account is understated, how do you correct this particular error? You correct this particular error by adjusting the individual customer's balance. You need to adjust the individual customer's balance. That's error number one that can actually affect the control, receivable control account. Another error that we can actually notice that can affect receivable control account is that the total of cash received from customer recorded in the cash book has been posted correctly to the receivable ledger control account, but a receipt from a customer is not posted from the cash. You know, this is what I'm trying to say. Customer has actually made payment to, you know, made payment to an entity, meaning that that particular customer's account needs to be credited while bank is debited. That is a normal, that's a double entry transaction that you need to post there. Now, when all these balances were being taken, all the customer balances were being taken to receivable control account, the receipt from the customer was not posted to that particular customer's account. This will definitely make the receivable control account to be overstated. Why? Because it's being overstated because that particular receipt is supposed to reduce what the customer is actually owing the company. But because the receipt was not posted, the customer's account has been overstated, and the balance in the receivable control account is also overstated. So how do you correct this type of error that I'm talking about? What do you need to do? What you need to do is that you also go to the individual creditors, individual suppliers and customers account, and adjust that particular that particular customer's balance. You need to adjust that particular customer's balance. That's how to correct it. You know, you don't need to cram this thing. You know, your correction is actually depend on the nature of the error that occurred. It's just so straightforward. A customer is owing you 1 million naira at the end of a particular period. You know, maybe combination of 5 transactions, 200, 200, 200, 200 in 5 places, making 1 million naira. And the customer paid for the first one, paid 200,000 naira out of the 1 million naira that is owing you. And at the end of the day, the receipt was not posted, was not accounted for in the account. Now, in the sales day book, because if the receipt has been accounted for, the receipt supposed to be posted by crediting that particular sales day book account and debit your bank. But because it was not accounted for, you are still showing in your account that the customer is owing you 1 million naira, whereas the customer is actually owing you 800,000 naira. Now, after moving the balance in your sales day book to the receivable control account, you now discover this, this is an error. How do you correct it? You don't need to cram. What you need to do is to go to that particular customer that is causing an error. Which of the customer is actually causing, is actually making my account not to balance? Go to the customer and you adjust the account, the cost of the balance in the customer account, period. That is how to correct it. I hope I'm communicating. All right. The third error that can actually occur in the creditor's account, customer's account, is that the same day book may be added up incorrectly. You know, it's possible. The sales day book may be added up incorrectly so that the wrong amount is posted to the receivable ledger control, but the individual account in the receivable ledger are correctly posted. You know, it's very, very possible. Possible, especially some company that make use of maybe Excel or make use of calculator or make use of manual way of recording their transaction. It's very possible that when you are casting, you are adding up what the customer is owing. You mix a particular amount. And if you miss a particular amount, you know, it is the aggregate of what you have added up that you are going to post to the receivable ledger control account. But because you have missed a particular amount, this definitely will cause an error. And how do you correct this one? This one now is not a customer's account. It is error of casting. It is when you are casting your figure that you actually make an error. What do you need to adjust the receivable ledger control account in the general ledger? That is what you need to do. The individual individual customer's account is actually balanced, is correct. It is the casting that is wrong. It is the aggregate of the casting that you posted to receivable ledger control account. So meaning that the amount that you posted to the receivable ledger control account has been understated or overstated, as the case may be. And if this won't happen, the account that you need to correct is the receivable ledger control account that you need to correct, not individual customers' account. I hope that is actually clear. Another error that can actually that can affect a receivable control account is that a contract entry might be recorded in the general ledger, but not in the receivable ledger. What do we mean by contract entry? A contract entry is an entry that involves both payable and receivable. You know, it's very possible for you to have a customer and the same customer is also your creditor or your contractor. It's very possible. The customer is also your contractor. So if you have a contract entry, this can actually cause an error in your receivable control account. And how do you correct this? You need to adjust the appropriate record for the missing entry. For example, the customer is owing you 1 million naira, and you are owing the customer because it's your supplier 500,000 naira. Invariably, what it means that if you do net off, even though it is not allowed to net off, if you do a net off, what it means is that the customer is actually owing you 500,000 naira. Because of what? Because you are also owing the customer 500,000 naira. So, in a way, when you are trying to reconcile, when you are trying to post transaction like this, you know, there could be an error that will affect your receivable control account. And how do you correct this type of an error? You correct it by adjust the appropriate record, you know, appropriate record. The appropriate record in this sense could be that you want to adjust the supplier, you know, or you want to adjust the customer's account. So it could be either way. So that is how to correct it. So when you know what can actually cause your receivable control account not to balance, you know, or your individual account not to balance with your receivable control account, you will also know how to correct the account. You know how to correct the account. So the error that I've described above do not result in a difference in the total debit and credit entry in the general ledger. Consequently, the existence of an error will not be discovered by preparing a trial balance. What do I mean? You know, account is garbage in, garbage out. When you post a wrong amount, you post to a debit side and a credit side. This type of error that we just discussed now that happened between a creditor's a supplier's individual account and a receivable control account will not be discovered by merely looking at your trial balance. Why? Because what you posted to negative, you know, you debit the receiver, you credit the giver. So the error will not be discovered in your trial balance. The error will not be discovered in your trial balance. But the error can only be discovered by control account reconciliation. That is the only way that you can discover such an error. So how do we now prepare a receivable control account? We have been able to talk about receivable control account. We talked about the reconciliation and why those things that can actually cause an error. So I'm moving straight to how do we prepare a receivable control account. How do we prepare a receivable control account? Just short. To make a control account reconciliation, the starting point are compare the control account balance with the total of all balances in the individual customer's account. You need to compare, you know, that is the starting point. You need to compare your receivable control account balance with all the customers that all the customers that are actually owing you, customers that you have posted to your sales day book, you know, all the aggregates. If you add all your customers together and compare it with the balance in your customer or receivable control account, if they are not the same, it means that there is an error which needs to be reconciled through receivable. Period. So it means that this nation is calling on you. The constellation is sorry, a moment. Okay. I think I can continue. So what I'm trying to say is that I saw that a correction might involve changing the control account balance or changing one or more balances in the customer's account. That is how we need to correct whenever there is discrepancies between receivable control account and customer's account. So let's look at this in simple example. Just a simple example. Example one. The balance on Yusuf receivable ledger control account on 31st December was 3.8 million. Was 3.8 million, which did not agree with the total, with the net total of the list of receivable ledger balance at that particular date. The following error were found. Number one, debit balance in the receivable ledger amounts to 103,000 had been omitted from the list of balance. Debit balance in the receivable ledger amount to 103,000 had been omitted from the list of balance. So this is a particular error. This is one of the errors that I described. You know, this particular amount was omitted from the Yusuf account. From the Yusuf, Yusuf is a debtor, a customer's account, is a customer to this particular entity. So this particular amount was omitted. How do you do it? How do you correct this one? Based on what you have discussed, you go to the customer's account and adjust for it. Number two, a bad debt amount to 400,000 had been written off in the receivable ledger, but have not been posted to the bad debt expenses account or enter in the account, in the control account. Now, what happened? The bad debt, you know, how you post the bad debt. Bad debt is an expense account. An expense account, what do you do? An expense account is actually, what's it called? what do? You debit the expense, a bad debt account, and you credit the customer's account by reducing the balance in the customer's account. Now, the bad debt was actually correctly posted to the ledger, to the receivable ledger account, but have not been posted to the bad debt expenses account, meaning that individual account has not been affected. Because if it has not been posted to the bad debt account, I'm sure that Professor has actually taught us on the bad debt yesterday. So So I believe that you know how to pass a ledger that involves a bad debt and a customer by debiting the bad debt and do what? And credit the customer. So number C, an item of a good sold to Eric, 250, had been entered once in the sales day book, but posted to his account twice. See, this is an error. An amount, 250,000 error, was posted to that particular account twice, is an error. The meaning that the account has been overstated by 250,000 error. So what you just need to do is to correct it by doing what? How do you correct an account that is overstated? If it is an asset account, you do what? You debit that particular account in order for you to reduce the balance in the account. Number D, 25,000 error discount allow to Godwin had been correctly recorded and posted in the book. The sum had been subsequently disallowed, debit to Godwin account, but not enter into the general ledger. This is an error. You know, I've told us, I've showed to us in the format given to us on how to post a discount allow by crediting the customer's account, the receivable control account. But at this stage, we have been told that the amount was not recorded in the general ledger. The amount was not recorded in the general ledger. So you need to control it. You need to correct it. Number A, no entry had been made in the control account in respect of a transfer of a debit of, this is a direct lodgement, debit of 700,000. From a Monday account in the receivable ledger to his account in the payable ledger. So this is another error that can actually cause the receivable control account not to balance. And lastly, the discounts allow column in the cash account had been undercast by 140,000. Discount allow has been undercast by 140,000. This is another error. So how do we correct this particular error? This is actually an ICANN question. How do you correct this particular error? The balance in the Yusuf receivable ledger control account was 3.8 million, which did not agree with individual. And we have been given the reason from number A to F, the reason why the balance do not agree. Now, after explaining this particular reason, let's look at how I have actually solved it so that we move on. So, require, make the necessary adjustment in the receivable control account and bring down the correct balance, then show the adjustment to the net total of the original list of balance to reconcile with this amended balance. So this is a question given to us. They will not tell you to prepare a receivable control account and prepare reconciliation. Now, look at the requirement. You know, we are not being told that we should prepare a receivable control account, but looking at the question, you should know that you have been directed to prepare a receivable control account and receivable control account reconciliation. The requirement say, make the necessary adjustment in the receivable control account and bring down the corrected balance Then show the adjustment in the net total of the original list of balances to reconcile with this amended balance. Meaning that you need to prepare receivable control account and at the same time prepare receivable control account reconciliation. Now, look at it. Look at it. No, this is not different from the format that I gave to us on a receivable control account. It's not different. In the format given to us, the balance receivable control account, you have the balance brought forward, which is 3.8 million. They said we have 3.8 million here, which is going to form our balance brought forward. You see, 3.8 million is going to form our balance brought forward. Then thereafter, you have number A. Number A said debit balance in the receivable ledger. In the receivable ledger amount to 103,000 had been omitted from the list of balances. So this one will not affect your receivable control account. It will affect your receivable control account reconciliation. Number B, a bad debt. They are talking about bad debt written of 400,000. No, this one, they say it was not posted to the bad debt expenses account, meaning that it's going to affect your receivable control account. And bad debt, how do you do bad debt in the format given to us? I said that bad debt is going to be credited to the receivable control account while the individual customer's account is going to be, the expense account is going to be debited. So you can see here, this is the bad debt posted to the credit side of the receivable control account. So number C is also talking about an item of goods sold to Eric, 250,000, had been entered once in the sales table but posted to his account twice. You know, it was posted to his account twice, meaning that this particular transaction will not affect the receivable control account. It will affect the receivable control account to the consolidation. That is where you are going to make use of this particular transaction. Number D is talking about discount allow, reversal of discount allow. See, this is number D, talking about the reversal of discount allow. Why are we posting discount allow to credit and to debit side of receivable control account? Discount allow is supposed to be an expense which is supposed to be credited to the receivable control account. But this time around, we have been told that 25,000 Naira discount allowed to Godwin had been correctly recorded and be posted in the book, but the sum had been subsequently disallowed. It had been subsequently disallowed. Debit to Godwin account, but not enter into the ledger. You know, it was formally posted to the credit side of a receivable control account. It was formally posted to this particular side account, but it says subsequently it has been disallowed. That is why you need to reverse that particular amount because they say it has been disallowed. So you need to do what's going on, otherwise of what you have done before. That's why it was posted here. You can see it. Posted here as debit side to the receivable control account. And number E is talking about contract entry. See the transaction of a contract entry, 70,000, because of what? It's 70,000 from Monday's account in the receivable ledger to his account in the payable ledger. You know, it is a transaction that is involved both receivable and payable ledger. So it's going to be credited to the receivable control account. And lastly, is discount allow, which is F. Discount allow will be posted here. So by the time you do your debit and credit, you are going to have a balance carried down of 3,215,000, meaning that is actually what's supposed to be in the receivable control account of this particular entity, of this Yusuf account. What is supposed to be in the account is 3,215,000 as against 3,800,000. So you now move forward because the requirement say it say correct the balance. You have corrected the balance. This is the correction. You now say then show the adjustment to the net total of the original list of the balance to reconcile with the amended balance. Now this is the reconciliation that we need to do now. This is the reconciliation that we need to do now. Total balance in the receivable ledger is this 3,362,000. Omitted balance, which is number A, is 103,000. Collection of a double posting. We have a double posting that we see in number C. You see, an item of a good. So that was a double posting. The correction will be adjusted for from the balance. And when you adjust the correction, what do we get? We get a balance of 3,215,000. As you can see, this 3,215,000 is actually correspond with the balance that we have in the receivable control account. So this is just a simple reconciliation of a receivable control account. We're going to look at the detailed one that we open our eyes. So before then, let's quickly move to the payable control account. I think that we can actually do a suspense account today. So we need to move a little more fast than we do. So payable control account, just the way we have a receivable control account, we also have a payable control account. A payable control account is an account for recording the value of a credit purchase transaction in total. The value of a credit purchase transaction in total. We have been told when we are treating those subsidiary accounts where we treated a credit, what's it called? A supplier day book. Supplier day book or purchases day book. When we treated purchases day book, we have been told that purchases day book is actually an account or is a book that we post all the credit purchase. All the credit purchase, that's what we post to purchases day book. All the credit purchases, what we post to purchases day book. So there must also be individual accounts for each credit supplier in a separate payable ledger. So the payable control account is an account for recording the value of a credit transaction in total with supplier. So the balance on the payable control account, which is always a credit balance, unlike receivable control account, which is a debit balance. You know, payable control account is always a credit balance. Why is it a credit balance? Because it's a liability account. Is a liability account. And where is it a liability account? It's an account that is housing all the supplier that you have not paid. Supplier that allow you to purchase on credit that you are going to pay in the nearest future. That is why it's a liability account. So it's a credit balance account. So the balance on the payable control account, usually credit balance, is the total amount of currently owed to all trade supplier. All trade supplier, note it, the amount that you are currently owed to all trade supplier, no? And the payable control account will contain some or all of the total to date for all of the following posting to the account, all of everything posted to the account. All right, just the way we have format for the receivable control account, we also have format for payable control account. Mind you, don't forget that payable control account, we have a credit balance. We have a credit balance. So in our format, we have a balance brought down in our credit side on payable control account. You can see balance brought down in our credit side. And we have all the purchases that you have made in credit. Credit purchase posted here. All the purchases made on credit will be posted here. Okay. All the purchases made on credit will be posted here. Okay. Now, if there is any payment, what do you do? What is the normal accounting transaction that you pass whenever there is a payment made to your supplier, to your credit, to your supplier? What do? You debit the supplier's account and you do what? You credit the bank account. That is the normal way. You debit the supplier's account and you credit your bank account. Why do you debit the supplier's account? You debit the supplier account because you debit the receiver and do what? You credit the giver. You know, you debit the receiver, you credit the giver. You debit the receiver, you credit the giver. That's how we, I mean, that's how we normally, you know, say it. Debit the receiver. Who is receiving? Your supplier is receiving. And who is giving? Your bank is giving. You debit the receiver, you credit the giver. Discount received. Discount received. When there is a discount received, it means that you are reducing the balance that is being owed to the creditor. So you debit the discount, you debit the discount control, payable control account, and you do what? When you debit the payable control account, the discount received is an income. An income account is a credit account, right? You credit it and you debit the discount, the payable control account, while you credit your P&L account. Purchase return, you debit it. Contract, you debit it. So these are the transaction. Ordinarily, these are some of the transactions that you need to post it to the debit side of your payable control account. And at the end of the day, you have a balance brought, balance carried down, and the same balance will be brought down. Sorry, you can change this one to balance brought down. The same balance will be brought down and to form the balance that should be, that you should have in the individual supplier that you are holding. Payable control account reconciliation. Payable control account reconciliation. So the same way we have a receivable control account reconciliation, we also have a payable control account reconciliation. A payable control account reconciliation involves a comparison between the total on the payable control account and the list of balances in the payable ledger, in the list of balances in the payable ledger. So the comparison or comparison between the payable control account and the list of balances in the payable ledger is what it is, and is what payable control account is involved. Why is it that there might actually be a difference between a payable control account and between a payable control account and individual suppliers account? Why? Why is it that there might be a difference? I have four reasons here. There are more than this anyway. I have four reasons here that I've actually put down here that we are going to take one after the other and how we are going to treat it. Number one, the total of the credit purchase in the payable day book is correctly credited to the payable control account, but one of the individual transaction is not posted. One of the individual transactions is not posted from the purchases day book to the individual account in the payable ledger. What, how do you correct this one? You correct it. This is an error. And how do you correct it? You correct it by adjusting the individual, not customer. Please. Individual creditors account. Individual creditors account. Please just correct it to individual creditors account, not customer. Individual creditors account. Please just correct your note. Individual creditors account. Even this one supposed to be individual creditors account. Please just correct your note. Okay. Number two error, the total of the cash paid to suppliers. The total of cash paid to suppliers recorded in the cash has been posted correctly to the payable ledger control account. But a payment to supplier is not posted from the cash book in the individual account in the payable ledger, what do you need to do? You need to also adjust your creditor's balance account. You need to adjust your creditor balance account. What we are trying to say here is that this can actually cause a discrepancy, or it can cause a reconciliation issue, difference between the balances in individual creditor's account and payable control account. If the total cash paid to supplier were recorded in the cash book and were not, and I mean, were recorded in the cash book, but the payment to the supplier was not posted from the cash book to the individual's account, it will cause a discrepancy. It will cause a difference between individual creditor's account and payable control account. And number three error that can actually occur. Number three error that can actually occur is that the purchases day book may be added up incorrectly. You know, just like in the sales day book may be added up incorrectly. So the purchase day book also may be added up incorrectly. And if the purchase day book is added up incorrectly, what you just need to do is that it's just for you to adjust the payable ledger control account in the general ledger, and everything will be okay. You know, what you just need to do is for you to just know what is actually causing an error, what is actually causing discrepancy or difference between your individual creditors account and payable control account. And once you are able to note or to pin down what is actually causing the difference, you know how to correct it. It's either you correct it in your ledger account or you correct it in the creditors, individual account. So, contra entry, just like the way I explained it under receiving control account, contra entry is an entry that involves both receivable and payable transaction. So, if whenever there is a contra entry, if it is not well posted or well monitored, there might be an issue that can cause a reconciliation issue. And how do you need to correct this one? You just need to adjust the appropriate record for the missing entry. Adjust the appropriate record for the missing entry. You know? So I also have a very short example under the payable control account reconciliation. I also have a slight example under the payable control account reconciliation. Okay. The balance on the payable control account was 971,860 as at 31st December. Balances extracted from payable ledger on this date total 962,380. You see, there's a difference. You know, the balance from creditors' account is totaling 962,380 naira, whereas your payable control account is showing 971,860 naira. You know, no accountant will accept this one. There's an issue, there's an error which needs to be reconciled. So the error could either be from the payable control account or from individual creditors account. Okay. Now, in examining the account, we have some list of transactions that can actually help us to know what is causing the error. The purchases day book was undercast by 60,000 naira. This will definitely cause an error. Okay. Number two. A cash account total 108,580 naira was posted to the control account as 90,580 naira. You see, the amount are under posted or undercast. So the amount that's supposed to be 108,580 naira was posted as 90,580 naira. Number three, a credit balance of 13,860 naira on the supplier's ledger has been set up. This is a contract entry, has been set up against a customer ledger debit balance, but no entry has been made in the control account. You see, this is a contract entry, but we have been told that no entry was made in the control account. So a credit balance of, lastly, a credit balance of 37,620,000 had been omitted from the list of the balances, you know, this is error of omission. So this also we cause a discrepancies, or we call different between the aggregate of all the suppliers account and the purchases control account. So let's quickly look at the solution after explaining the question to us. Now, don't forget, I told us that the purchases debit book, purchases and control account, we always have what? We always have a credit balance account. Purchases control account, we always have a credit balance account. So balance brought forward is there. 971,000, that's the balance brought forward. You can see it here. They said the balance was 971,860. So 971,860 was actually posted here. And we have been told that the purchase debit book was undercast by 60. If the purchase debit was undercast by 60, what do you need to do? The purchase debit book was undercast by 60, meaning that the balance taken to purchases, payable control account has been also been undercast. What do you need to do? You need to post it. You need to correct this transaction by increasing the balance in the payable control account. And how do you increase it? By crediting the amount. This is it. Purchase debit book under cash 60,000 naira. Purchase debit book under cash 60,000 naira. You can see that it's actually straightforward. A cash account totaling 108,580 was posted. This is an error. You are meant to post 108,580, and you post 90,580. What is the difference? The difference is that you have undercast the payment that the supplier made, that was made to the supplier by what? By the difference between this particular amount and this amount. So if you minus this amount from this amount, you'll be getting the amount. We'll be getting 18,000 naira. So what means is that the 18,000 naira was not posted. It was only this one that was posted. So if you are meant to post 100,000 naira, you post 90,000 naira. You made 10,000 naira, you need just to post it. And if you are to post it because you want to reduce the balance that you are owing to the creditor, what do you do? You credit that payable control account. You credit it. Credit it by you debit it by crediting your bank. So this is the transaction here. Number three is talking about contract entry. 13,000 naira that was set off between the payable and receivable. This is it. Any contract entry in the receivable control account will be posted to the credit side, while contract entry in the payable control account will be posted to the debit side. So if you cast this one, you have a balance carried down of 1 million naira. And balance carried down of 1 million naira. Then you do what is called your receivable control account reconciliation. Total balance in the receivable ledger, 962. We have been told that total balance in the receivable ledger is naira. This is it. Where is it? Naira 62,380. Where is it? Where is it? Okay. Where is it? 962,380. So we have been told that the total balance in the receivable ledger is 962,380. And this is not balanced with there's a difference of 1,000,000. So omission, there was an omission. Number four was talking about an omission. There was an omission of balance, which is 700. So if you adjust the omission, you will get the balance brought forward of 1,000,000. If you minus this omission, you add this particular omission to this amount, you will get this 1,000,000. Sorry, 1,000,000 is just jumped down. So that is how to correct a payable control account. That's how to work a payable control account. So let's look at this examinable question. This is an examinable question, and it's an ICANN question, by the way. I just want us to look at this so that we can just refresh out what we have discussed in the past. Examinable question. Okay. The preparation of a control account requires information from a different unit, both within and outside the account department of an entity. Mr. Gongo, a partner in the partnership business of a Winners Enterprises, is worried over the absence of the information needed for the purpose of determining the account receivable and payable balance required. In a tabular form, highlight three sources of information required and the account recorded from which such information is obtained for the preparation of creditor receivable control account and account payable control account. Account receivable control account and account payable control account. You see, this is actually a bonus mark. It's an ICANN question, 12 mark, a bonus mark. They want us to do in a tabular form, to highlight three sources of information required and the account record from which such information is obtained. Account record from which such information is obtained. You know, you can even do more than three, but they want us to do three. Now, let's see here. I do like 6-6, even more than that, like 7-7. You know, for example, cash payment, let's take for the receivable first. This for the receivable for information that you need to be that be posted. Okay. Payable balance brought forward from the previous account. How do you get it? Opening balance figure from the statement of financial position. Credit purchase, where do you get your credit purchase? Or where do you get the credit purchase information based on what you have discussed in the past? You get the credit purchase information from the purchase journal or purchase day book. Return outward or return or purchase return. Where do you get it? You get it from return outward journal entry, return outward journal, or return outward day book, return outward journal, or return outward day book. That's where you get it. Check paid to supplier. Where do you get check paid to supplier? Where do you get the information? Bank account or bank statement. Cash paid to customer. Where do you get it? Cash book. Discount received. Cash book. Dishonor check. Cash book. You know. These are just a simple information, simple question that we don't need to waste time on. You know, the question is asking us to provide information. See, in a tabular form, I like three sources of information required, and the account record from which such an information can be obtained. You can obtain cash paid to supplier information. You can obtain it from where? From cash book. Discount received, you can obtain it from where? From cash book. Check paid to supplier, you can obtain it. Check paid to supplier, you can obtain it from what? From bank account or from bank statement. That's simple. Credit purchase. Credit purchase, you can obtain credit purchase from where? from credit purchase day book or from purchase journal or purchase day book. So that is the same way we are going to answer the one that has to do with receivable. Cash received from customer, discount allow, dishonor check, all this information can be obtained from cash book, Return inward can be obtained from return inward day book. Check received from customer, you can obtain this one from cash account, from bank account or from bank statement. You can obtain all this information from bank account or from bank statement. So that's it. Let's quickly look at the example two before I go to the next things to discuss. Example two, examinable question two. There are different methods through which a business might make payment to supplier and receive payment from customer. Since it's different methods, this one I did not put the answer here because I know it's part of what, this is also part of what we discussed last week. Method of making payment, can make payment via check, can make payment via transfer, can make payment via draft, can make payment via check, via cash, can make payment via bank transfer, can make payment via standing order, can make payment, several means. It's an icon question, you know, they say you should state six methods by which you can make payment. This is a bonus question, 6 marks. This is a bonus question, and it's just 6 marks. Okay, number B, explain the following. Receivable control account, payable control account, 3 marks. Receivable control account and payable control account, explain it. So you need to talk about receivable control account and payable control account. When you're talking about receivable control account, you're talking about customer's account. You're talking about customer's individual account, aggregate of customer's individual account that must be equal to the receivable control account. And when you're talking about payable control account, you're talking about the creditor's individual's account. Addition of all the creditor's individual's account that must be equal to balance in the payable control account. And if these are not so, if they are not equal, what you need to do? You do what is called a reconciliation. Reconciliation is allowed in account, in financial accounting. Reconciliation is actually very, very key. Reconciliation is very key. It's the foundation of our knowledge in accounting. You must know how to do reconciliation. Be it bank reconciliation, ledger reconciliation, balance sheet reconciliation, any form of reconciliation, you must know how to prepare reconciliation. It's very, very key. So number C, we've answered number A and B. Number C, the following information are extracted from the record of OJ Limited for the period ended September 30. So we have this balance of the receivable control account was this, and the total of the balance extracted from the receivable control account was this, meaning that if you see any different amount like this, it means that the reconciliation is calling on you. The reconciliation is saying you should come and do reconciliation. That's what it's saying. If your receivable control account is showing 1,134,000 and your individual ledger is showing 1,020,800 naira, it means that you need to do reconciliation. Number two, the balance on the payable control account was 570,500 naira, and the total of the balance extracted from the payable control account amounts to 455,380 naira. It means that there is something is very, very wrong, because the amount, something is telling me that 570,500 naira is not the same with 455,380 naira, meaning that reconciliation needs to be done. The cash account total 65,750 naira was posted to the payable control account as 56,760,000. What do? You minus, you see what has happened. It has actually been undercast. You want to put 65,000, you put 56,000, minus it, and you do what? You debit your payable control account, minus it, you debit your payable control account with the difference, because the amount that you're supposed to post was actually higher than the amount that you have posted. So the difference needs to be posted to the payable control account. We have started answering the question, so I don't want to waste much time on it. That's why I'm answering it now before I show us the solution. Number four, no entry has been made in the receivable control account in respect of the transaction. No entry had been made in the receivable control account in respect of the transaction of a debit of 112,000 from a creditor and a customer account in the receivable ledger to his account in the payable ledger. An item of a good worth 115,000 was sold to the customer, had been entered once in the sales day book, but posted in the account twice. You know, the amount was posted in the account twice, so you need to revise it. And this one is talking about sales, it's talking about the receivable. When you want to revise an amount in the receivable account, since the receivable is a, since the receivable is a debit balance account, so if you want to reverse an amount, you do what, you credit it in order to deplete or to reduce the balance in the receivable account. Number seven, a credit purchase, a credit balance of 62,320 naira has been omitted completely from the list of balances in the payable ledger. Now, the balance has been omitted from the list of the balances in the payable ledger. So this also needs to be corrected, but here you correct it in the payable control account. Correct this one in the payable control account. So a smart student, what I expect you to do in question like this, you know, this is an ICAN question. What I expect you to do is that one by one, you know, you can actually open your ledger down, open the creditor control account, and open the customer control account, and at the same time open your reconciliation account, you know, for both. So once you are treating this question one after the other, just start posting it in order not to waste much time on it. Number eight, six return by a customer totaling 73,400 have not been recorded in the receivable control account, but are included in the customer account balance. Six return by a customer. Total 73,400 have not been recorded in the receivable control account, but are included in the customer balance account. So go to the format that I've given to us in the receivable control account. You see how I've treated return. You see how I've treated sales return there. That is the same way you are going to treat number eight. That is the same way you are going to treat number eight. Credit sales of 43,200 naira to a customer had been recorded in the customer's account in the receivable ledger, but is included in the control account balance. Okay, we'll also look at how we are going to treat that. The purchase day book was overcast. The balance was overcast. Purchase day book was overcast. Now the purchase day book was overcast, it means that this one now, it will not affect your purchases. We do not have your payable control account, it will affect the reconciliation that you're going to do. So let's look at the suggested solution. Number B is the explanation given on the receivable control account. Please make sure you read it, because you never can tell. The past question, I can test it again. is actually one of the areas of concentration, areas of AOC. So this is the solution. The solution will not be different from how I have explained it. The receivable control account will start with the debit balance. You know, this is the debit balance, and you have a contract entry. You have the contract entry, in the account, and you have a sales return. The sales return, when there is a sales return, if the forward give it to us, we have it here also, and you have a balance brought forward, balance carried down, and you have. So when you do your reconciliation, you must get this particular balance brought forward. You must get this particular balance brought. So look at the reconciliation. It's also the same thing with what we have done in the past. It's the same thing with what we have done in the past. Likewise, purchases control account and the reconciliation is also the same thing with what we have done in the past. So let me just use the remaining 30 minutes to discuss correction of error. Correction of error. So far, we have been able to discuss the receivable control account and payable control account, and at the same time, the reconciliation of both receivable control account and payable control account. So please, if you have question, you can actually drop your question in the chat button. We will treat the question after the class. Please, if you have question, just make sure you drop your question there. We'll treat the question after the class. But before then, let's quickly look at the correction of error. Correction of error. How do we correct error? And why do we correct error? How do we correct error? Why do we correct error? We cannot talk about correction of error without talking about tribalance and without talking about the purpose of the tribalance. So I will start by talking about the tribalance. I will start by talking about the trial balance. The other lecturer has actually taught us on how to raise some ledger and how to post all those ledger into our trial balance. So that will actually help us on what trial balance is all about and the purpose of the trial balance and how to actually use the trial balance to correct our error. So a trial balance is a list of all the debit balance and the credit balance on the account in the general ledger. A trial balance can be extracted from the general ledger simply by listing the balances on every account. So the normal method of presentation is to present the balance in two columns. You know, you have a debit balance and you have a credit balance. You know, every account statement, the trial balance must balance. If the trial balance does not balance, it means that something is actually wrong. That is when you'll be talking about the suspense account. So the trial balance must balance. In fact, a good auditor will start his work from trial balance. And a good accountant will also start his work from trial balance. A trial balance will show you the true picture of your account. You know, I remember then my boss used to tell me that a good financial accountant, we always want to look at the trial balance. You know, we always want to check the trial balance and carry out the reconciliation of the trial balance. You know, it's from trial balance that you know that if your account is actually wrong and your account is actually right. If an asset is turning to negative and a liability is turning to positive, something is telling you that a wrong posting has been done, which you need to correct. So that is the purpose of a trial balance. So a trial balance has two main purposes. It is a starting point for producing a statement of profit or loss and a statement of financial position. You know, when you are giving a trial balance, from a trial balance, you can actually prepare a statement of profit or loss account and a statement of the financial position at the end of an accounting period. So a trial balance is extracted from a general ledger and a various year-end adjustment are then made to the account, which are recorded as a journal entry before being entered into the general ledger. So year-end adjustments include adjustment for opening and closing inventory and so on and so forth. A lot of things can actually form a year-end adjustment. It could be adjusting your inventory. It could be adjustment to your depreciation charges. It could be adjustment to your accrual and prepayment. It could be adjustment to your bad debt, your customer. You know, adjustment can come in different areas. So, you know, when your trial balance is actually, you check your trial balance and your trial balance must actually balance. After your trial balance is balanced, the debit side is balanced to the credit side. You know, the any adjustment that needs to be passed, you pass through adjusted trial balance. And when the adjusted trial balance is being passed, it's also going to affect your ledger. You know, that is how, you know, the trial balance is being adjusted past the entry through the journal by raising different journal. When you are raising journal, it will definitely affect your trial balance. But at the end of the day, the trial balance, the debit side and the credit side must always balance. So that's number one purpose of the trial balance. It's actually used as a starting point to prepare P or L account and other comprehensive income, and also the statement of a financial position account. I hope I'm not too fast, because I realize that I talk fast. I'm sorry if I'm just too fast. I will slow down a bit. A second purpose of a trial balance is to check for error in the accounting system. Number one is a starting point for preparing financial statements, and number two is a starting point to check for an error in the accounting system. Trial balance is a starting point to check for an error in the accounting system. So error must have occurred if the total of debit balance and the total of the credit balance on the general ledger account are not equal. It means that error has actually occurred. So that make me to discuss various type of error that we have. We have various type of error in the double entry accounting system. We have various type of error that we are going to talk about, but tonight we are going to talk about just four type of error in the double entry accounting system. So we are going to talk about four type of error. So you can be asked that list and explain four broad category of error. These are the four type of error that we have. These are the four type of error that we have. Sorry. Number one is error of transposition. Number two, error of omission. Number three, error of commission. And number three, error of principle. Error of transposition, error of omission, error of commission, and error of principle. Those are the four error that we have. Those are the four error that we have that we are going to be talking about. So let me take them one after the other. From the word transposition, you can easily know what I'm talking about when we call transposition. You know, in the past, we have seen a lot of questions where you want to write 10,500 and you wrote 9,500. This is what is called a transposition error. Or you want to write 7,900 and you wrote 9,700. This is what is called a transposition error. So from my note here, you see here that this involves getting the digit in a number the wrong way. For example, you want to record 9,700 and you use it to record 7,900. This is what is called error of transposition. And how do you correct this an error? You know, sometimes the error will be made in both debit and credit entry in the ledger. For example, a purchase invoice might be recorded as 1,750 naira instead of 1,560 naira in both the purchase account and the payable ledger control account. So the trial balance will not review this sort of an error because of what? You know, please underline this one. This particular error, transposition error, the trial balance may not review this type of an error. Why? Because it is what is posted to individuals' account that is also posted to purchase control account. So it means that the tribalance will not reveal this type of an error. So the tribalance will not reveal this type of an error. Sometimes the error of transposition will be made in one account, but not the other. For example, if a payment of 1,080 from a customer might be recorded correctly in the cash book, but posted wrongly in the posted only in the receivable ledger control account. This type of an error, it will be reviewed in the tribalance. This one will be reviewed in the tribalance. Why the one posted them making the same mistake in the individual's account and the control account will not be reviewed in the tribalance. Next one is error of omission. I'm sorry, this one's supposed to come down. Sorry, it is when I want to make the notes PDF that all this thing jump. Sorry for that. So the next one is error of omission. From the word omission, you know, this is where a transaction or entry is mixed, is practically omitted from the book. Sometimes a transaction is missed out of the ledger entirely because the bookkeeper forgot about it or is not even informed about it. So a transaction may be omitted. You know? So error of omission is when a transaction is completely omitted from the book. So that's what is error of omission is all about. Next one is error of commission. Error of commission, this means putting an entry in the wrong account, commission. Commit an error. Putting an entry in the wrong account is what is called error of commission. Error of commission. For example, I have an example here. A telephone expenses in the electric, you put an, a telephone expenses in the electricity expenses account. Similarly, discount received might be recorded incorrectly in the discount allow account, you know. It's an error of commission. And lastly, error of principle. Error of principle. This is where an entry is recorded in the wrong type of an account. Don't mix error of principle with error of commission. Error of commission is talking about putting an entry in the wrong account. You want to record into the salary account. You go ahead and record it in the pension account. You want to record in the transport account. You mistakenly now record it in the telephone account. This is error of commission. Unlike error of principle, this is where an entry is recorded in the wrong type of an account, e.g., record the capital expenditure as a revenue expenditure. Record an expenses as a capital expenditure, an OPEX expenditure as a, you record it as a CAPEX expenditure. So that is error of principle. Error highlighted by extraction of a tribalance. What are the error highlighted by extraction at the value? One way of finding some error in the accounting record is to extract a tribalance from a general ledger. If the total of the debit balance does not equal the total of the credit balance on the general ledger account, then an error or several errors have been made. If the trial balance does not balance, then this will be due to an error where the debit and credit are not the same. So that the error results in the debit entry in one account in the general ledger not being recorded to a matching credit entry in the another account. So this is actually an error that you can actually be discovered in the extraction of a trial balance. So I have some type of error here that can affect the balancing of the trial balance. I have a list of error here that can actually affect the balancing in the trial balance. List of error that can affect the balance in the trial balance. Number one, there could be a transposition error in one account. That's it. You want to post 1234 and you post 1324. Okay. Number two, a transaction might be recorded as a debit entry in tool account. So that's number two. Error that can affect trial balance. The transaction might be recorded as a debit entry in two accounts. Number three, a transaction might be recorded as a credit entry in two accounts listed instead of being debit entry in one account. So there is another error. And also, there might be a mistake in casting. This is another error that can also affect the trial balance. This is another error that can also affect the trial balance. So please note this, that correction to error in an account, correction to an error in an account system are recorded as journal entry and then posted from the journal to the relevant account. It is through journal entry that we record transaction, that we correct an error. And after the journal entry, it will be posted to a relevant account. I'm sure that Professor has actually taught us on how to post from journal entry to individual or relevant account in the general ledger. So error not highlighted but extraction of a trial balance. What are the error not highlighted? A trial balance is only used in helping to identify error where the debit and credit entry in the general ledger account do not match. So it does not help with the identification of error where there has not been a mismatch between debit and credit, I've told us that one. So there are some type of error that do not result in the difference between total debit and credit entry, and therefore do not affect the balance of the trial balance. Errors such as a transaction might have been omitted entirely from the general ledger with no debit entry or no credit entry. If a transaction was entirely omitted, there is no way trial balance will not review such an error. Trial balance will not review such an error. A wrong figure might be double entered. If a wrong figure was actually double entered, also is also an error that may not be reviewed by the trial balance. Transaction might be recorded in the wrong account. Transaction also might be recorded in the wrong account. So that's just it. That's it. So how do we approach an error in order for us to correct the error? I have some steps on how we can actually correct whenever there is an error in our account system. I have some steps here. I'll take them one after the other. Transactions that have been omitted from the general ledger entirely should be recorded. Yes. Transactions that have been omitted should be recorded. Entry that have been made correctly in the account must be corrected by means of suitable debit and credit. Yes, that's the approach. If there is any transaction that was not posted rightly or correctly, you need to correct it by means of debiting the account or crediting. You see how we have done the correction of error in the receivable and payable control account. And also, you need to identify the error. You need to recognize that. What's the correction by means of double entry adjustment. Double entry. You need to pay more attention on your double entry. A good accountant must not have problem with double entry. Immediately, you are having problem with double entry, it is very difficult for you to be a good accountant. So once you are able to master your double entry, debit to the receiver, you credit to the giver. You know the account that has a debit balance account, and you know the account that have a credit balance. So once you are able to master all this one, you can actually cross my finger that you are going to be a good accountant, and you are going to correct an error. It's going to be very easy. You know, I will always advise you that whenever you want to correct an error, always use your till account, till account, till account. You know, there is another account anyway, but at this level of ours, till account is the best way of correcting an error. When you draw your till account, it will definitely help you to know the account that you want to debit and you know the account that you want to credit. So let's quickly go and consider what suspense account is all about, and we call it a day. What suspense account is all about, and we call it a day. We have a question here. Okay. So what error are made where the amount of the debit entry differ from the amount of the credit entry? The total debit balance and the total credit balance in the general ledger account will differ. A balance will be demonstrated and the existence of such an error. So this error must be discovered and corrected. Until they are discovered, the first step should be to open a suspense account. Again. So when you discover an error, or until you discover that particular an error, the first thing that you need to do is that you open a suspense account. From the word suspense, you open a suspense account. You know, when you open the suspense account, you know, I mean, when you open the suspense account, when error have resulted in the total debit entry and total credit entry different and being different, the error are corrected using a suspense account. That's number one. Number two, a suspense account is not an account that will be there forever. It's not an account that is going to be maintained forever. It's a short-time account that is required only until the corrected. When the error is being identified and is being corrected, you see that the suspense account will be written off, the suspense account will just be closed. How do you open a suspense account? For example, a business has prepared a trial balance, you know, trial balance of the general ledger account. And this shows total balance of 465,000 and total credit of 488. Meaning that there is a difference. Total balance total debit 456 and total credit 488. We have a difference of 32,000. So what happened? A suspense account must be opened, and the balance on the account to make debit and credit balance equal is to debit the suspense account by debiting 32,000 and credit. Debit the suspense account, that's 480,000 credit less this particular amount is give us 32,000. So when you debit your suspense account, the trial balance will be balanced. So when you are able to now identify the error, you can now close this particular suspense account by correcting an error and credit this particular suspense account, and checking on the suspense account is closed. So let's look at the errors where a suspense account is opened. When it is clear that an error has occurred, it is often helpful to decide the answer to the two questions. Has the error resulted in difference between total amount for the debit and credit? If yes, making the correction will involve the suspense account. And if no, the correction should be made, but will not involve the suspense account. That's number one. Has the error resulted in different total amount for the debit and credit? If the answer is no, is yes, it means that you are going to open the suspense account. But if the answer is no, it means that you don't need to open suspense account. Number two, if the error has resulted in different total amount for debit and credit entry, think about the general ledger account and account containing the error and decide what to be done to correct the balance on the account. So at this juncture, you will need a T account. You will need a T account. So these are actually the way of how to maintain the suspense account. These are the way of how to maintain the suspense account. I have a question here which I want you to actually treat. I want us to treat this particular question. No, I want us to treat this particular question. I have the solution there, and it's an ICANN question. The solution is actually there. It's an ICANN question. So I want you to look at the question. It's one of those things that we have been discussing. So if you have any challenge or you meet anything that is not clear to you, you can drop your question in the WhatsApp group. We are going to address it. And I believe that we are actually ready. So I will need to, before I call it a day, because I can see that we have just 5 minutes more. Before, let me see if we have any question. And then let me see the suspense account balance listed in client balance. No. Hey, Mr. Kenny, the suspense account balance listed in tri-balance? No, the suspense account balance is not listed in the tri-balance. You don't list the suspense account balance in the tri-balance. So when you open your suspense account balance, for example, you will see, let me show you this, ledger, this journal. Your suspense account balance, will only appear in your journal. And when your suspense account balance is appearing in your journal, you know, you open the suspense account because the error has not been identified or the error has not been discovered. So once the error is discovered, the suspense account will automatically need by the time you correct the error. So the suspense account balance is not listed in the tri balance. Thank you. Any question? You can also drop any question. So in the absence of no question, let's just look at this particular question. And I want us to treat the question on our own. And the requirement is talking about the journal entry and prepare the suspense account. And once you are able to deal with this particular question, you are home and dry with what is called reconciliation and the suspense account or correction of error. So I believe that we have enjoyed this evening class. And then if you have any question after the class or when you are reading your book, you can actually drop your question and on our WhatsApp group, you know, and your question will be addressed appropriately. But before then, please make sure you read this question and try to attempt before you look at the solution. So next class, we are going to, if you have any question, I'm going to address it next class. And if you have any area, any gray area, we are going to also address it. So thank you, and God bless you. Once again, my name is Ayodeji Ajimoko. Thank you for listening to today's lecture.